Recently, Google made some major updates to a very popular Android Auto app that many drivers use in their cars. Some updates address the problem that many of you complain about. I will demo something very interesting in this video because I had so many questions from everyone on that particular subject. If you've never used Android Auto app before, watch this demo that I'm about to show because I think you're gonna like it. Coming up right now. Many people ask me why I need to use an Android Auto app in my car and mess with the USB cable. Especially the new cars, they come with state-of-the-art multimedia navigation and phone integration. So why would you need anything else? Well, let me show you a few examples. Go to Trader Joe.
Please select from the following locations.
Now, as you can see, navigation lists all Trader Joe's by the distance. 3 miles, 3.3 miles, 5.6 miles. But the nearest one is 2.7 miles. So it's almost 3 miles from here, right? But here's the problem. I can assure you, it's a lot closer than 2.7 miles. Actually, it's no more than 20 feet from where I am. Here is another one. Go to T-Mobile.
I cannot find the address of the selected contact. Do you want to enter an address now?
Sometimes can't find an address. And sometimes doesn't even understand what I'm saying. And when it finally found an address, you see the one 200 feet from here? It took me to the place which was out of business for over 6 months now. My accent is not easy to understand, I get it, but I don't have any problem with Google Assistant. Yes, Mercedes provides you with the software updates, but it's only once a year and it's free only for a couple of years. But when you use Android Auto, it's always up to date and it's always free. Plus, it's extremely accurate, so you can actually rely on it. Now, let's take a closer look.
The most exciting feature of this new Android app is the split and fill the whole screen. You would immediately think that the latest Mercedes-Benz MBUX big 12.3 inch screen would benefit the most. After all, Mercedes-Benz was one of the first vehicles supporting Android Auto since 2017. So it would be the first to get the full screen, right?
When I heard about new widescreen Android update, I went to this Mercedes and I tried it right away. And as you can see, after I connected, bam, it doesn't work on Mercedes yet. This screen is 12.3 inch wide, but an Android app keeps its aspect ratio, so you can see these visible black gaps on both sides. So right now, if I want to change any app, I have to open new window every time. For example, if I want to open Pandora radio, I have to open this particular app and I can see only one window. You see maps are over there, so if I push I can see maps, but I cannot see both at the same time. And it's very disappointing because this display already supports dual screen. As you can see on the parking, you see two screens, 30% and 70%. And also after the latest update, augmented video can be split as well.
Well, at the time of making this video, in March of 2021, Mercedes MBUX models are not compatible just yet. However, Google swears they're working on compatibility very soon. Meanwhile, I'm gonna demo this feature on a different vehicle. which is already compatible with the latest feature. So you can actually see what's coming to your car very shortly.
This is 2020 Jaguar F-Pace, but as I said, these new updates already work with a lot of different cars. You just have to check with your own car. So in order to use your phone with the car, first you have to locate USB connector, and you have to make sure that's the right one, because a lot of cars have some USB connector specifically made for working with the Android or Apple phones. Now let's close it. Now if you look at the screen of this car, you can see it's white, and Android app aspect ratio is not white. So how is it gonna work? It will actually split the screen into the multiple windows. Let me show you, this is very cool. Wow, that's much better. Let me bring it a little bit closer. So now you can see main window, which takes 70%, and the second window, right now it's occupied by Pandora radio, is 30%. And also on the left side, you can see all the controls. So you have 70% main window, 30% secondary window, and I can control both on the same screen. So I can change the song on the Pandora radio while still looking at the map. So I don't need to close anything, both are visible to me. If I go to a main menu, you see the radio still stays on the right side. So I still have two screens. I can pick a menu and navigation map is back. So I can also switch them place by touching. So 70% window is reserved for the app that you currently use. But for example, if I go to navigation and I start navigating to this address, it will automatically move it to 70% screen.
Head southwest.
So the screen splits in two windows, 70% and 30%. 70% is for the main app and 30% is for the secondary. And you can switch them between each other. Right now I'm controlling the Pandora radio, but the navigation is on the secondary screen, still providing guidance. We actually get three sections: main section, secondary section, and controls. A little bell displays notifications. It displays only compatible notifications, very similar like you have notification area on your cell phone. But it only works with apps that's installed in your car. Microphone is for the voice control.
Find nearest gas station.
Here's what I found along your route for find nearest gas station.
Now you can see all the gas stations sorted by distance, and you can also see them on the map, and when you go further it zooms in and zooms out. So for example, I get this Chevron, it gives you all the information: open 24 hours, address, phone number, how many miles, when are you gonna get there, and it will send you direction. You can close it, you can save it. If you hit cross, it will stop guidance. You can still use your original voice control by pushing button once, or you can use Android voice by pushing the same button and holding for about 4 seconds.
Call Kate London.
Calling Kate London.
And as you can see, the phone is displayed together with the navigation. It took the secondary screen. And you can hang up, it works with all the original buttons.
Text Kate London, I'm coming home.
So, that's a message to Kate London saying, I'm coming home. Do you want to send it or change it?
Send it.
Sending your message to Kate London.
Google Assistant is like a real person. You can ask her any questions and she knows the answer.
When did the First World War
started.
World War I lasted from July 28, 1914 to November 11, 1918.
There is no car in the world that can give you all this information like Google can.
Who won the Stanley Cup in 2020?
The 2020 Stanley Cup Finals was won by Tampa Bay Lightning.
On the navigation, you can see all the recent addresses and also saved addresses. Also the time to destination, if you decide to go there, based on real traffic. You can save the favorite addresses. You can just search by categories, like gas station, restaurants, for example. So right now we show you on the map, 1, 2, 3, 4, and if I go zoom out, it will zoom out. So you can see all the restaurants, you can go right there. There is no limit to how much information you can get. You can see the secondary screen right there, but if you want, you can change it for something else. For example, if you go to main menu, a lot of apps, Android Auto wants to keep less visual. Like for example, messages. There is nothing here. So for your safety while you drive, it wants to use a voice.
Who do you want to text?
Kate London.
Kate London, sure. What's the message?
What time are you coming?
So, that's a message to Kate London saying, what time are you coming? Ready to send it?
Yes. Yes.
Sending your message to Kate London.
Some other apps that prefer to use voice are, for example, Facebook Messenger. Doesn't want to show you anything. Or, for example, let's see, Skype. Android Auto works perfectly with your phone. Even better than most cars. It shows your favorites, recent contacts. You can call right from there. You can see what happened before. And also it works as a second screen. You can see, you can switch screens in between. This is Pandora Radio. You can use podcast. I don't have any. Maybe I should set up. It's much more interesting than listening to news. And you can change to different app, like for example, Samsung Music, which is similar to Pandora, or you can use whatever you like. But it's also integrated with the original radio. If you hit the button, like Jaguar, for example, this is Jaguar. And let's say you go to media. And now you can switch the source from Android Auto to just radio from the car. So now I can use Android Auto over here, like for map, for example, and listening to the vehicle radio. So it's integrated perfectly with the original radio.
I'm Mike Simpson.
And I'm Karen Adams, our top local story at 4:03. LA County officials expect to get out of the strictest...
Now, because I didn't pick the secondary screen, it just displays clock and date. But as soon as I pick something, now I have two screens. I don't have anything on Samsung. Let's go back to Pandora. So here you can select station, you can select music that you like, and based on this music, it will play. Let's say, for example, this station. It doesn't matter. So let's set destination, and from one touch, it goes right there.
Head northeast, then turn right.
Like on usually on navigation, you have to press a couple times. Let me show you one more interesting thing. If you go to settings, it's available on most cars right now, but most people don't even know about it. If you go to, these are all your options, but if you go to satellite and turn it on, wow, that changes the appearance drastically. You can see actual houses, trees, streets, like street dividers. You can see it's like virtual reality, and you can actually zoom in and zoom out, and you can see like actual aerial footage. Or you can hit recenter and it will go to bird's eye view. You can also change the direction of the map facing north or facing the direction of the car. If you lose a signal, you can pinpoint yourself. And you can zoom in and out very close. Let me show you an example. I'm standing on this street, and let me zoom in. I'm gonna zoom very close. Now you can see the street, you can see houses around me. So I can actually move, and I can see the solar panel on the roof of this guy. And I can see these two guys have big swimming pools. I can just see the aerial footage where I'm standing. This is like unbelievable. There is so much information you can see around you. There is no way you can see it from your car, just standing on the street. Now, any additional settings you can change from your cell phone. A lot of people are asking me, how do I get new application for Android? You cannot get it from the car. You actually have to get it from your cell phone. Next time when you connect to your car, the app will be available over there. So you can change a lot of things over here. For example, notifications, preview incoming messages. Preview incoming messages. You can turn it on. I don't need it. I'm just showing you, but I'm going to turn it off. You can also auto-launch Android app only with specific cars. You can select which one you want. There is a lot of information over here. I'm not going to go through everything, but it shows you data, version, etc. But what's important is apps for Android Auto. That's where you go to get a new app for your car. You cannot add apps inside your car. You have to do it from your phone. So there is a lot of things like Waze navigation. But what I want to get for my car is this one, Audible, for the podcast and audiobooks. And you can see 100 million downloads, you can read reviews, etc. Now let's see how it looks while you drive. You can see the real streets from the bird's eye view. And it actually zooms in and out automatically. So for example, right now I'm approaching the corner.
In 1000 feet, turn left onto the ramp.
It zoomed in. So you can actually see the street and you can see houses around you. It's unbelievable. Now when I go on the freeway, you see it automatically zoomed out. So now I can see from the bird's eye view the whole picture. If I stuck in traffic, you see it's all red. So it gives you information that there is a traffic. Let's try to zoom closer. You can actually see the street. It's like virtual reality. You can see the freeway right now. Let's zoom closer. You can see your car, you can see the freeway, you can see all the houses. You can see the speed limit. You see 65 miles per hour that nobody actually follows. And I can come really close right now. And you can see similar ETA, so it keeps popping up. So it offers you different direction all the time. You can change your direction at any time you like. Let's come as close as we can. Right now, we're super close. You can see the freeway, you can see cars on the freeway that were taking shots from the satellite. And that's the maximum how close we can come in. You can see entire freeway covers entire screen. And you can still have the radio on the right side, so you have double screen. Anytime you hit recenter, it goes back to the bird's eye view. Anytime something going on, like for example, I'm gonna take
the interchange on the right, then keep right at the fork.
Ramp, it zoomed in automatically. I didn't do anything. And once you leave the ramp, it zooms out and you're back to the bird's eye view. Beautiful. And the question of today is, do you use Android Auto or Apple CarPlay in your car? Why or why not? Please let us know in the comment section below.